One of the biggest talking points coming away from the Starfield teaser trailer actually has very little to do with Starfield at all, but rather something to do with one of the Easter eggs in the trailer that people seem to believe may just be yet another hint towards The Elder Scrolls 6 and where that might be set. If this is the case, it's not the first hint we received, the first one being this trailer. Some internet wizards used the geography shown in the trailer that released back in 2018 to figure out that if the setting shown was accurate and honest, it's Hammerfell, or even maybe High Rock. Reddit user Huftblur made a post on r/gamingleaksandrumors pointing out an etching on a side of the control panel in the Starfield trailer and compared it to a reference map of High Rock and Iliac Bay. Do I see it completely? I mean, sort of, yeah, but also it's a little bit different. Some people, of course, have other ideas as to what it looks like. But maybe the vague resemblance is so people can't outright go, oh, look, it's High Rock and Iliac Bay etched into the side of this control panel in Starfield. If it were too specific, it would definitely be seen as a hint and then the game would be up. The more it looks like ambient detail, the more subtle the hint. But you've got to remember, every detail like this in video games or even trailers of video games using in-engine footage is deliberately placed. This is here so that people see it. Bethesda Game Studios' next title after Starfield is out the door is of course going to be The Elder Scrolls 6, and thus it makes sense for this to be a hint towards what the setting might be for this game. It could be a complete red herring, which would probably suit the sense of humour behind the secrecy of the games industry a little bit. However, were that the case, I'd expect it to be a little bit more obviously placed to make sure that people don't miss it, all the while making it look like a hidden detail. Then again, someone was going to point out this squiggle, and now we all know about it. It's also worth pointing out that Elder Scrolls fans have been waiting since 2011 for a brand new mainline Elder Scrolls entry, which isn't, of course, Skyrim being re-released again just for the Tesla this time. Obviously, you've got the Elder Scrolls Online, but come on, who has an extra 3,000 gigabytes of space laying around? Or however big that game happens to be these days. Furthermore, as cool as MMOs are, they don't just capture the magic the same way. My point being, maybe fans are scraping the bottom of the barrel a touch. But we're now closing in on that decade mark since Skyrim. It's pretty hard to imagine that there's much else to do for Elder Scrolls fans anticipating their favourite series. Furthermore, it's not like it's the only grounds for people's theories about the next Elder Scrolls being set in the High Rock Hammerfell area. Like I said, people use the geography shown in the trailer to figure out where it could possibly be, and that was the conclusion. In their 25 years of the Elder Scrolls video they showcased a couple of years back, they showed us their use of photogrammetry and development, and they showed us rather arid looking rocks. Now Hammerfell has a desert, so people thought, oh, maybe the next Elder Scrolls is set in Hammerfell. However, maybe they're bullshitting us and this is for Starfield. You cheeky fucker. They're showing us the technology they're using. This could be a test or it could be for a different project, but that doesn't take away from the fact that this is the technology they will be using for The Elder Scrolls 6. So there's no knowing for sure with this one, unfortunately. However, people may take it as a hint. Furthermore, there was a time where rumors circulated that The Elder Scrolls 6's subtitle would be Redfall, which would have indicated some arid desert-like setting. However, Redfall turned out to be Arkane Studios' upcoming title, which is releasing in summer of 2022 and is completely unrelated to The Elder Scrolls. Regardless, at the time that made people believe they were a step closer to knowing what the setting was for the next Elder Scrolls title, even if this piece of information turned out to be completely unrelated, which it did. Also, on the 31st of December 2020, The Elder Scrolls Twitter account posted this image with the caption, "Transcribe the past and map the future. Here's to a happy new year." With many people acknowledging the candle over Hammerfell, believing it to be a hint that that could be a part of the next game's setting. So I think it's fair to say that it's not just this squiggle that's making people look at these regions as possible settings for the next Elder Scrolls title. Because in the end of the day, it's only really vague similarities between this doodle and the map of High Rock and Hammerfell. But when you combine it with everything else that people think they know, I can see why you'd want to connect the dots. However, fans will not know if they're right until E3 2169 when Cyborg Howard takes to the stage and reveals The Elder Scrolls 6 finally. But until then, at least we'll get Starfield in 2022. Right. Anyway, that's the topic of today's video expired. I see no reason to waste your time any more than I already have. But it must be pretty peak for Bethesda Game Studios waking up to find the internet not interested in the game they're working on, but completely fixated on the game that they're working on after they finished with this one. On a serious note, Starfield does look interesting, and I am curious to find out more, but after Fallout 76, Bethesda Game Studios definitely needs to prove something to its consumers, and it'll be an interesting gauge point for The Elder Scrolls 6 as well. Is the design philosophy at Bethesda Game Studios still complacent? And on that point, seeing is believing. Anyway, thank you all for watching this video, I hope you've enjoyed. Be sure to go ahead, leave a like, subscribe, share the channel with your friends and all that wonderful stuff, that would be super fantastic. And with any luck, I'll be seeing you all very soon with another video at some point. But until next time, take care and goodbye.
They burnt my house!